everyone, and welcome to Wintercrest Park for CTN's coverage of Metro Mini Baseball. Tonight, the Redbirds take on the Brooklyn Park Norsemen. Joe Yanhai Shapiro behind home plate, and I seem to be saying this every time we're at the ball game, but beautiful weather for baseball.
Yeah, it's a little cloudy, so the sun isn't playing any problems with the field here at this point, but it is a beautiful, beautiful night. We've had a couple of them in a row.
So look at the lineup. Unfortunately, it's the Brooklyn Park Norsemen, and they will somehow, for some reason, be the home team.
I don't understand that.
No one informed this crew of...
Well, you know, we fly by the seat of their pants.
The generous nature of the Redbirds to give away home field advantage. So instead, it will be Jake Paler leading off for Coon Rapids. Dan Skoe, Keen Paxton also due up here in the first inning to face Brandon Rushmeyer.
Redbirds coming off a win over Andover. That was yesterday, a 7-1 win.
Paler shows bunt, pulls back, takes a fastball for a strike. It's 0-1.
Paler's hitting 278 as he steps to the plate. Yeah, we'll have to try and get some sort of clarification as to why they're up first. But Brandon Rushmeyer, pitcher for Brooklyn Park, very good one at that, coming off a fine high school season at Champlin Park.
This one hit back up the middle, stopped up by Lyons. A throw over to Wozniak in plenty of time for out number one.
Rushmeyer comes with a 2-2 record, a 1.67 earned run average. He's thrown 37 and two-thirds innings, given up 32 hits, 10 runs, 7 of those runs earned.
Here's a look at the Redbirds lineup. Skoe digging in, Keen Paxton, the DH behind him, Grant Farley, Patrick O'Donnell, Zach Saylor, Tyler Stein, Jake Bruner, and finally Jeremy Tutt. Skoe looks at a fastball for strike one, and then that one is inside and got him. And a free base for Dan Skoe.
Yeah, we actually saw that happen in the last game with the Redbirds. I can't remember who was the batter at the time, got hit by a pitch, but it just grazed his jersey. Brings up Keen Paxton.
So look at the Norsemen in the field. Zajac, Kelb, and Kaminsky patrolling the outfield grass. Wozniak and Vance on the right side of the infield. Lyons and Solwald on the left. Austin Ledeen behind the plate for Brandon Rushmeyer. Paxton. First pitch to Paxton is outside, ball one. Paxton, now you can say
thanks,
that.
I appreciate it. Paxton hitting 321 on the season, he steps to the plate. Wasn't here for the last game we did. They were missing a few players. Missing a few players today as well as in the game before. I was talking to Coach Bright about that, and he said, you know, sometimes this time of year, it's tough to get players before some guys go back to school and some are taking a final vacation before school year starts.
Two and 0 now to Keen Paxton. Skoe the runner at first, one out. Left fielder Grant Farley awaits on deck. That one floats in for strike one.
Nice pitch. You know, we saw Rushmeyer pitch at Champlin. We did see him pitch in Legion as well.
This one swung on, popped up right side of the infield. In foul territory is Wozniak. He's under it for out number two.
That's a big second out for Brooklyn Park. You got a runner at first with two away. Just be concerned about that hitter at the plate. Get out of the inning. Grant Farley hitting 250.
Farley hoping to get a little something going against Rushmeyer here in the first outing of the ball game. That first pitch just fouled on the left field line.
Yeah, good thought by Farley too, trying to pull that ball down the line. He's got pretty good speed. He's trying to hit that ball in the corner, see if he can stretch it for two.
Ball one chop foul. That one's up high, 1-2.
Brooklyn Park coming in with an 11-7 record on the season. 24-11 for the Redbirds. So we talked about Brooklyn Park coming off a loss and Coon Rapids coming off a win coming into this evening's contest.
Runner is going. Farley fires another one foul. Rushmeyer throwing him a lot of strikes, but a good battle being put up by Grant Farley. Another 1-2 pitch inside, and that clipped him.
Oh, they're saying no, it didn't.
Saying he clipped him, but he ducked into it. So 2-2. Runner off again. Farley underneath this one. It's backing out of play. And the at-bat will continue.
I thought I saw Brandon Ricker kind of reaching for that. Thought he was going to dive over the top of the truck, but thought better of it. He's a daredevil.
Curveball in for a called strike. And a good start for Rushmeyer and the Norsemen in the field. Their first chance to bat when we return on CTN. Beautiful summer skies overhead at Wintercrest Park as we get ready for the bottom half of the first inning. A little bit of town ball, Metro Mini Baseball, Coon Rapids and Brooklyn Park.
Yeah, both teams have pretty respectable records. Of course, Coon Rapids for sure at 24-11. The Norsemen at 11-7. Now we get that Brooklyn Park line.
There it is. A.J. Lyons, the shortstop, will lead things off, followed by Trevor Kaminsky. Seth Solwald hitting third with Austin Ledeen in the cleanup spot. Daniel Kelb, Jared Vance, Calvin Spencer, Brandon Wozniak, and finally Tony Zajac round out the order for the Norsemen, who had a relatively quick inning in the field in the top half of the inning and are hoping they can have a little bit longer trip through the bottom half of the inning.
I spoke with Coach Bright, this is their home game. This is their home game. So that is why the Redbirds are up first, the visitors. Carson Saleen on the mound. We saw him earlier. Comes in with a 2-0 record, a 3.15 ERA facing A.J. Lyons, who's hitting 308.
Saleen with a strike at the knees to start the inning.
Yeah,
inside.
Lions come in, Norsemen come in hitting 251 as a squad. Is that one a little bit low to the inside?
Little break on that one, running back in on the right-handed hitting A.J. Lyons. But he was not offering. Not 2-1. Celine kicks and fires, down and in again.
The Lions with some good speed on the base pass. They want to keep him off it because he's a good hitter, and Trevor Kaminsky behind him.
And after a first pitch strike, four straight puts him on first base.
Kaminsky hitting 380 on the season.
Celine out with a man on, nobody out. Comes across the plate and starts out in front of the count.
Well, as you mentioned, what he did to when he faced A.J. Lyons, but does not want a repeat of what happened four pitches after.
Well, he tried to work the inside part of the plate to Lyons. See what he does here with Kaminsky. This one again going inside with that little two-seamer breaking back in against the righty.
When his pitch is just a little bit off, enough where the Brooklyn Park batter is going to make sure that that pitch is in their sweet spot in order to hit it.
Check the runner, Lyons. He's back safely. Jake Bruner, the opportunity to start over there at first. And Kaminsky, or Lyons rather, not taking a real big lead. 1-1 as Celine comes set and comes again inside to the right-handed batter. 2-1.
Stein took a look down at first, as you mentioned. Lyons not with a big lead off the base. Although he does lead the team with four stolen bases.
Again inside, 3-1.
Some control issues in terms of finding the zone early on here for Carson Celine.
And that means Kaminsky should get something good to hit here on 3-1. Instead, it's down and in again. And back-to-back walks to start the outing for Carson Celine. Here's a look at the defense behind him. Patrick O'Donnell, Jake Paler, and Grant Farley are your outfielders. Jake Bruner at first, Jeremy Tutt playing second. Doug Skog is the shortstop. Zach Sather at third. Tyler Stein is behind the plate. And Carson Celine is looking to get an out here as he faces Seth Solwald.
Solwald hitting 333 on the season.
Down in the dirt, good stop there by Stein.
And he is the leading producer of runs batted in for this Norseman squad. So a good spot for him to be up. An opportunity to continue to drive in runs this season.
High and away, 2-1.
And both pitchers really taking their time on the mound. And Stein's gonna go out early and talk to Carson Celine, talk about things, and trying to set him down a little bit, having issues finding that strike zone.
Well, 12 pitches into the ball game for Stein, just two for strikes. Thank you. Good fastball in for a strike. And Solwald, I'm guessing, just not going to swing until he's got a strike.
Well, yeah, you want him to bring, they're pretty patient hitters at the plate, and you want them to bring that to you. And if he's going to continue to be out of the zone, they'll continue to take walks.
Outside, 3-1. And now Celine in danger of walking the bases full. First three he faces, and cleanup man Austin Ledeen on deck. Strike at the letters, makes it a full count.
Again, Solwald taking out long on that pitch at 3-1.
See what Celine has for 3-2. Outside, ball four.
Well, base is low with nobody out.
And now here comes Coach Lindstrom.
Well, you're going to have to make
talk to his starter.
You know, and he has to. He's got to make an early trip to the mound. He's nobody out, base is loaded by three walk. You have to be concerned. You don't want to have a big inning here, but it's a drive to the gap away from a big inning. And another pretty good hitter come to the plate in Austin Ledeen, hitting .344 on the season.
Well, a great opportunity here against a pitcher struggling to find his rhythm. Bases loaded, nobody out. And you know he's going to come, especially with that first pitch, he's going to try and throw a fastball right down the pipe.
Well, he wants to start off with a strike, absolutely.
Unfortunately, Ledeen will be sitting on that pitch. Celine needs a ground ball back to the mound. Instead, he's up high, 1-0.
Some early work in the bullpen for Coon Rapids. Joe Lewis getting some warm-up tosses.
Way up high, 2-0. And this is definitely not the same Carson Celine we saw the other night.
No, that he had a pretty good outing that night.
High again, 3-0.
Yeah, he's just having a hard, he can't throw strikes at this point.
And a four pitch walk will bring in the game's first run.
Get a Coach Lindstrom walking over to the bullpen. See if he lets him face another batter. I'm assuming that. I think he's going to put in Joe Lewis here. Making a early change. I think it's obvious to Coach Lindstrom that.
He's calling time.
Yeah, he's calling time here. He's not gonna.
He will have to make a change with the second trip to the mound in the first inning. Not at all how the Redbirds expected or wanted to start, but they will make a change and hopefully try and stop the bleeding here in the first. We leave with the bases loaded, nobody out, and one run already across. You're watching Metro Mini Baseball on CTN.
Disease affects one in every three women in America, but you can fight back. There's no time to lose. Mothers, sisters, daughters, families, and friends, it's time to shout louder, stand stronger, and demand change. Let's go!
To the Batmobile. Dang it.
To the invisible jet.
Dang it.
Together, we can put an end to heart disease. It's time to go red for women.
I could use your help. Yeah!
Learn more from the American Heart Association at www.goredforwomen.org.
So who's going to do what?
I'll pack the dead batteries.
Great.
I'll only put what I don't need into a duffel bag.
Perfect. That's totally unhelpful.
No problem.
Meanwhile, I will try to comfort everyone by speaking in a calm voice.
And who is going to handle supplies?
I can forget to do a list for us.
Thanks, pal.
We couldn't be any less prepared. I'm proud of you guys.
Talk to your kids about who to call, where to meet, what to pack. Visit ready.gov/kids for tips and information.
Back at the ballpark, and an early call to the bullpen will bring Joe Lewis out with the bases loaded. Nobody out here in the top of the first or bottom of the first inning. And the Brooklyn Park Norsemen, four straight walks to start the scoring.
It's a tough way to start this game if you're a Redbird fan. Lewis takes the mound. He's got a 1-0 record with a 3.48 earned run average. He's pitched 10 and a third innings, given up seven hits, five runs, four of those runs earned. Four base on balls and 10 strikeouts in 10 innings. That is impressive. But he comes in with a tall task, Joe, as he comes in with bases loaded, offering to Daniel Kelb. Kelb, a 150 hitter. But you were right before, a ground ball back to the mound is exactly what they need.
Or a sharp one to third base would work too.
That would work as well.
5-2-3 is not as cool a double play as 1-2-3.
No.
But in the Redbirds' favor, they would definitely take it. At this point, they just want it out. We'll see what happens here with Joe Lewis throwing to Kelb. First pitch is down and away, 1-0.
Get a good pitch, hit it hard somewhere. Come on.
Good fastball at the knees, 1-1.
Yeah, I like the fact that with the velocity and the fact that he's keeping it down in the zone, I mean, exactly what you want to do, because if the contact's going to be made, good chance something will be hit on the ground.
Another one right at the knees, and Lewis jumps ahead in the count, 1-2. 3-2-3 would work.
This is true.
You know?
Yep.
4-2-3 would be rare, but it'd be cool. But I think if it goes in the middle, you'd probably turn to the traditional way.
Yep. Hey, you'll take the easiest way to turn two.
You'll allow another run for those two outs.
Right.
We are
2-2 now to Dan Kelb.
We are guests. Good. Great.
Came down and in on Kelb, and the count is full. Base is loaded, still nobody out. And a big pitch for Joe Lewis to his first batter. Stein flashes the signals. Here comes the lefty with the heat, gets the swinging strikeout and a big out for the Coon Rapids Redbirds.
It really is, because now if you can induce a ground ball in turn two, you're out of the inning with just the run, one run. Nice pitch from Lewis there to get the K.
Second baseman Jared Vance will come in. Corner infielder still up on the grass for Coon Rapids. Fastball in for a strike, and Lewis ahead with an 0-1 count.
Vance starts us at bat, hitting 266 on the season. Opportunity
good
for him.
Breaking pitch, but stays just outside, 1-1.
Opportunity for him to see if he can get an RBI in his at bat. He's got four on the season.
This one chop back to the left side. Sather will come home for one. The 5-2-3 will end the inning. Just the one run scores. Joe Lewis, a good job mopping up. Brooklyn Park, the early lead. We go to the second on CTN.
news, you'll notice we're different. It's about the people, the places, the stories that affect your life.
We're local. We focus on the local communities, the local issues, and the local stories.
They're the stories that impact you, the stories you won't find anywhere else.
It's the people, the places, and the events that make CTN so interesting.
It's about connecting you to your community, one story at a time.
There's a shelter pet who wants to meet you. Meet one today. Visit theshelterpetproject.org. Adopt.
Back at Wintercrest Ballpark, and I tell you, Brandon Rushmeyer was thinking to himself, oh, great, I'm going to have a huge lead. Four straight walks.
And, didn't turn out
that
way.
The bases full of opportunity.
Well, nonetheless, he does have a 1-0 lead.
Which is better than nothing.
Absolutely. Better taking a lead than being tied or being down.
Right fielder Patrick O'Donnell will lead off the second inning for the Redbirds.
Donnell hitting 245 as he steps to the plate. Redbirds like to see if they can get their bats going here in the top of the second and get at least that one run back.
Shows bunt, pops it up behind home plate. Ladine had no idea where it went, so no opportunity to try and track it.
In that 7-1 victory over Andover last night, the Redbirds collected 13 hits.
We have yet to see a hit.
Well, Jeremy
in this ball game.
Went 4-for-5 in that game.
Swinging strike as Rushmeyer blows the heat past O'Donnell. And a pitcher's count at 0-2.
Thought about it.
That one misses just high, 1-2. Took a little something off and got O'Donnell out in front, swinging through. Second strike out of the ball game for Rushmeyer.
Watch that ball drop at the end. It's a nice pitch.
Zach Sather will come in, looks at a pitch outside, 1-0. And then the fastball, he can't quite catch up, 1-1.
Say they're hitting 226 on the season, working on that average.
A speed pitch, belted to right, and it'll foul for a solid single. First hit of the ball game for either team.
A one-out single by Sather gives the Redbirds an opportunity to see if they can get something going.
Speed pitch, left hanging, a little below belt high, and Sather strokes it to right. Tyler Stein. First pitch, high fly ball to right. Plenty of time for Zajac to get underneath that one for out number two.
First pitch swinging, got underneath that fastball a little bit. As you mentioned, Zajac with an easy play in right field.
Bring up Jake Bruner.
We've seen play, of course, over the years. Jake hitting 318 on the season.
Good pitch right at the knees. Get Rushmeyer heading the count 0-1.
Jake played football, baseball, and hockey, I believe. Hockey too, correct?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Reach for
this
that
one. Popped up right side. Underneath it is Wozniak, and a relatively quick inning for the Redbirds at the plate. Brooklyn Park trying to extend their 1-0 lead when we return on CTA.
Oh, hi. I'm TV's Howie Shapiro. And when I'm not announcing CTN sports broadcasts with my sidekick, Joe Yen, I'm watching all the other great programs on the CTN Studios YouTube page. There's news stories, great local events, and even full games. You can even watch on any smart device with a YouTube app. Whether that's your phone or a tablet, you can watch CTN's great programming wherever and whenever you want. You can even watch CTN's event coverage live. So no matter where you are, you can share in all the excitement. CTN Studios, building community through cable.
Good crowd on hand at Winter Crest for a beautiful Monday evening at the ballpark.
It is a beautiful night. Very pleasant.
We have had outstanding weather.
Let's keep it up.
For just about every game we have done all summer.
We've really been very fortunate.
Really all spring, too.
Yeah, we've been very lucky in that respect.
Not a lot of...
And then football starts soon. It could be driving rain. We'll still be there. Won't matter.
Well, I've spent many a ball game shivering behind home plate, and I don't know
yes,
that
we
had.
We have. We haven't done that this year, I don't
that
believe.
At all this year.
I think one game early on in the high school season, I think it started out kind of nice and got a little chilly, but other than that, we've been fortunate for weather here in this area because, as you know, it can change the drop of a hat.
Calvin Spencer leading off for Brooklyn Park, takes a pitch on the corner down and in for a strike, and now inside evens the count. Joe Lewis came in with the bases loaded, nobody out, got a strikeout and a double play ball. This one skied to right. O'Donnell waits, squeezes, and there's one away.
Yeah, Salim just didn't have it this evening, and his location was off all night for the inning that he was in, or less than an inning that he was in. And you're right, Lewis has come in here and has kind of calmed down that area for the Redbirds.
Brandon Wozniak, the first baseman.
Wozniak hitting a .182 as he steps to the plate.
Fastball popped up, back and out of play. Good pitch, called a strike.
Well, he's had that part of the plate, that location, that low fastball right around the knees. He's been throwing nice pitches in that area, keeping the Norseman hitters at bay.
Goes down there again, gets Wozniak swinging for out number two.
See that pitch again, watch it drop at the bottom, and Wozniak's going to swing through it. Good job by Stein to hold on.
And a great job by Stein to apply the tag just to make sure he did make that catch.
He did.
But even he wasn't sure. And surest way is just to reach out and tag him. But he did make a nice job. A nice job of scooping and squeezing.
Tony Zajac hitting .235 on the season.
This one chopped off the plate down the first baseline, and it'll run foul in front of Bruner. Pushing the count to 0-2.
Yeah, a good spot for Lewis to be in. Looking looking for a solid inning.
Goes low, gets the swinging strike. This one did hit the dirt, so they have to throw down to complete it. But a quick 1-2-3 inning for Lewis and the Redbirds. They're back at the plate, trailing 1-0 when we start the third after this.
Everybody has a dream. Mine was to see the ocean. And with a little help, I made it.
Every day across America, excess food is gathered by a network of good people at local food banks, giving hope to millions of children who struggle with hunger. They've earned their wings, and you can too. Together, we can solve child hunger. Support Feeding America and your local food bank at feedingamerica.org.
Gentle breeze stretching Old Faithful just a bit.
Just a little bit, not much.
Not enough to move baseball.
No,
carry it. Not that extra effective. 5 or 10 feet.
Absolutely.
Not gonna happen tonight. Jeremy Tutt leading off the inning for the Redbirds. Looks at a fastball for a strike, going one.
Tutt hitting 306, as we mentioned, coming off a 4-for-5 day with three RBIs yesterday.
This one ripped down the line in fair territory. Tutt going to turn big, and he will stop there. Kaminsky got over quickly and probably would have had him at second with a great throw into the bag.
Yeah, he's got a good arm from out there in left field, and wisely Tutt decided to stay at first. But a nice piece of hitting by Jeremy Tutt as he's continuing his hot start.
Leadoff single, and the Redbirds go back to the top of the order for Jake Paler. Another look at Kaminsky, getting over there quickly and getting behind it. Paler drops down a bunt on the right side, trying to win a foot race. The throw is in the dirt. He'll dig for third or second. Tutt will round and go to third.
That was Paler speed. You have to make a quick throw. And again, there was the first baseman came in, Wozniak, and he had to make sure that Rushmeyer was there. You're going to see it here as a nice butt, pretty solid. It worked out in his favor.
I'm guessing he didn't want to bunt it quite that high.
No, but
again, yeah, just a throwing error. And really, you know, they got crossed up because Wozniak has to get out of the way.
Yeah.
That's Vance's bag from second. And
Was Rushmeyer at the bag at first. Wozniak made the throw.
Rushmeyer has to
Get out of the way.
But it's his job to cover that bag.
That's
too.
That's true,
so.
Too.
I don't know. It was kind of hard. I kind of want to give him a single, but I think I'm going to put him on by a sacrifice. It'll go down as a sacrifice bunt. This one gets away from Ledeen. Both runners are going to advance. Tutt will come home, and the game is tied.
Yeah, quickly. And as Ledeen was running to the ball, I looked at his face, pained face, knew he let that ball get behind him. And we talked about it all the time. There's a lot of real estate behind home plate here, and an easy opportunity to score that run.
Look as it crossed him up. Pitch in there for a strike. It's 2-2. This one hits softly to left, out of the reach of the shortstop. Skold with an RBI single to bring home Jake Paler from third and put the Redbirds in the lead 2-1.
Nice piece of hitting there by Skog. Just got enough of it to put it up and over. Lines it short. No opportunity for Kaminsky to come in on the ball. He has the RBI.
Good fastball at the knees to start Paxton behind 0-1.
It's eighth RBI for Dan Skog on the season. Nobody out. Paxton looking to see if he can keep things going.
Fastball is going to miss high. Great throw. And Skog caught stealing.
Yeah, that was a pretty throw. Even though Skog got a pretty good jump. But Ladine behind home plate. Again, get a good jump. Watch that throw. It's right where it needs to be. Applies the tag and he's out.
Pitch is just high and it's 2-1 to Paxton.
You know, it's interesting, Joe, how a game can turn around. You look in that first inning like the Redbirds were going to give up a big first frame, and they were able to just limit to the one, and now you come back here in the third and score two, and you're in the lead.
And now a walk to Keen Paxton to replace that runner at first. Bring up Grant Farley. Farley punched out back in the first inning. Off-speed pitch, sky high to semi-deep left. Kaminsky there in plenty of time for out number three.
Yeah, he chomped out on that pitch, on that fastball, and he gave it a pretty good ride, but got underneath it just a bit.
Oh, sorry, second up. Rushmeyer starts with the breaking pitch to Patrick O'Donnell. He's not biting at the pitch down and away. This one hit high as well. It's a very short center. Back on it was Lyons, but Kell will call him off for out number three. Redbirds able to score two. They're back in front. Norseman, an opportunity to respond when we return.
I've got a job to do today.
I've got a job to do today.
Have a good first day at work, Mom.
Your donations to Goodwill fund job training programs right in your community.
Feels good to start fresh, right?
Sure does.
And like that, you're a job creator.
The next 30 seconds can save you a lot of money. Just do your laundry in cold and stick to full loads. Auto-sleep your computers. Plug your gadgets in a power strip and switch it off when you're done. Head it out? Turn back your thermostat by 10 degrees. And drive sensibly. The more energy you save, the more money you save. Find other great tips at energysaver.gov.
Couple of hits. The Brooklyn Park error. And the Redbirds able to capitalize with a couple of runs.
Yeah, do a nice job of getting this lead back.
Top of the order due up for the Norsemen here in the bottom of the third inning. Lewis looking for that corner down and away. Couldn't quite find it this time.
Well, these first four hitters for Brooklyn Park really didn't get a chance to get much contact with the ball.
Nice pitch in for a strike.
As there are four walks in a row, given up by Carson Saleen, the starter.
Well, he only threw four strikes to the four batters. This one skied to the right side in foul territory. Over for it is Bruner for out number one.
Jake Bruner does a nice job of staying with that, making sure he knew where that ball was. Bruner doing a good job coming over from first.
Bring up Trevor Kaminsky. That one skips on the plate.
Just a little to the outside.
Fastball, rip foul.
Mincy had a nice high school season for Champlin Park.
Lays off a breaking pitch that dies down and away and puts him ahead in the count, 3-1.
He's looking for his second free pass of the game.
Fastball in for a strike. And the count is full. Another fastball. Kaminsky missed it, and it skipped out of the glove of Stein, and he's going to be on a pass ball strikeout.
Again, that ball getting behind Stein and no opportunity for him to throw Kaminsky out. Norseman will take it.
Seth Solwald looks at a fastball for a strike. His first look at the left-handed Lewis.
And Lewis doesn't waste a lot of time between pitches. He works fairly quickly. Oh, just inside.
Fastball, and he can't catch up, 1-2.
Good spot for Lewis to be in this situation, ahead 1-2 in the count.
This one hit hard toward the corner and right, it'll fall. Good job getting there quickly by O'Donnell and getting the ball back in. But the single will push Kaminsky over to third with the tying run.
That was a nice piece of hitting by Saltwald as he drilled that ball down to right field. But you're right, Patrick O'Donnell using his quickness out in right field to get to the ball. But he drilled that base hit all along and he didn't get there quick. That would have been a double, quite possibly a run scored.
Yeah, just a great angle on the ball, good first step. Cut it off quickly. First hit of the ball game for the Norsemen. Austin Ledeen, you can add an RBI to his stat list, as he walked with the bases loaded to push the first run across. That one's in for a strike. Good breaking pitch in for a strike.
Yeah, that was pretty. You know, now in another good situation being ahead in the count 0-2.
Smart now, way up. Be smart.
outside. He's got a couple to play with now, 1-2.
Ideally, Lewis would like to get the K at the plate here to put some, a little less pressure on his infield. Get the second out of the inning.
Outside 2-2. To the left side, scooped up by Skog to Tutt. The relay is not in time. Run will score on a fielder's choice. We're tied again at 2.
It took a little extra time for Tutt to get that ball out of his glove, and he wasn't able to get it over in time for that double play. And as he saw it, leads to a run. Skog gets it over quickly to Tutt, but watches it. It has a little bit of difficulty, besides the fact that the throw is high, getting out of his glove.
So two out, a runner at first. We're all tied at 2. Kelb, the runner, gets stopped by Stein on the pitch in the dirt. Runner is off. The pitch is outside, and they're going to let him have it.
They got a good jump off the bag. And I think Stein felt that that he wasn't going to be able to get him with the throw down. Also looked like Kelb's bat was a little bit in the way of when he wanted to get rid of the ball as well.
Oh, that pitch was called a strike. Yep. 1-1. And now 1-2. Great pitch right there. Another strikeout for Joe Lewis. But the Norsemen score a run. We're tied at 2 after 3. You're watching Metro Mini Baseball on CTN.
Now it's time for This Week in Bad Stats.
Bad stats?
Horrible stats. Here goes. 132.
That's how many batters struck out 4 times in one game last season.
Wow, very good. Here's a tough one, though. 3-4.
No idea.
That's how many kids witness bullying. 3 out of 4.
That's not a good stat.
No, it's not, but it can change. Kids want to help, but they don't know how. Visit stopbullying.gov and give them the tools they need to help prevent bullying.
There are plenty of safe ways kids can help at stopbullying.gov.
This is my computer.
This is your computer. Let's go on the internet.
Let's go. Click it.
Yes.
Okay.
Eye cursor in between the R and the E. I say dot, I want you to just push the period.
She's gonna love me all over again.
That's it. Jamaica, here you go.
Here we go.
Good right. Job.
Thank you. Thank you. And I did it by myself. Feel smarter.
Welcome back to Wintercrest Field, where you're watching Metro Mini Baseball. Coon Rapids Redbirds taking on the Brooklyn Park Norsemen. Norsemen able to come back and tie this game up 2-2 in the bottom half of the third. So we move to the top of the fourth. Game tied. And the Redbirds coming to the plate. Zach Sather's going to lead it off. Third base minder for the Redbirds. You see his numbers 1-1 for a single. And my partner's back, Joe Yon!
Just in the nick of time.
Ah, feel better? Feel lighter?
I do.
Okay, good. Did you wash your hands?
I did. Well, sanitizer, that's all they have.
I know.
Zach Sather, as you mentioned, 1-1. Belt high fastball, strike 1. K good breaking pitch. It completely fooled Sather. It's 0-2.
Yeah, Rushmeyer, we've seen. He has very good stuff. That tall, lanky pitcher.
It's back to the fastball. Sather drives it toward the gap. It'll two-hop to Zajac, the right fielder, but it's a leadoff single.
He crushed that ball. But Zajac able to get over there quickly in right field to avoid an extra base hit. But nice way for the Redbirds to start, Joe, here in the top half of the fourth, base hit.
Well, if you think about it, though, with the composite bat, that one hops the fence most likely.
Probably.
Extra 20 or 30 feet on that bat, out of the bat itself. Versus the wood bats. This one skied into foul territory. Great effort from Wozniak, the right or the first baseman, but no chance to get that one. It's just a long strike.
Advanced second baseman coming over as well.
Stein will dig back in, now 0-1. Runner at first, nobody out here in the top of the fourth inning. 2-2 our score, reaches out and pokes this one down the line and foul. Just barely, or that would have been a whole lot of trouble.
Yeah, it could have been a little danger for Brooklyn Park. Rushmeyer still in control, hitting the count 0-2.
He's thrown nothing but strikes so far in the inning. Steps off the mound and bags Sather up to the bag. Up and in, 1-2.
Redbirds trying to see if they can get this lead back here. Their 2-1 lead didn't last very long.
This one hit right back up the middle, skips away from the shortstop, able to recover it, pick it up, throw over, great scoop. But he's unable to come up with it. And it'll be a fielder's choice. Sather was off with the pitch. It was a hit and run, but hit right to Vance on the move. He bobbled it a little bit, able to scoop it up. And they nearly turned the double play.
Yeah, I mean, and they still had plenty of time. If that would have been a good throw, they would have converted that double play. Stein not the fleetest of foot.
And now Jake Bruner. Breaking pitch in for a strike, 0-1.
I'm not really sure who's running on first. I believe the uniform number is 24, but I don't see a 24 on the roster.
This one foul, back and out of play. Three-pitch strikeout of Jake Bruner. Statement by Brandon Rushmeyer for out number two.
Yeah, good control again. Out number two, as you mentioned, and an opportunity now to see if they can. Rushmeyer just concerned about the hitter at the plate and Jeremy Tutt.
Tutt, first pitch, hit to third. Solwald takes his time, makes a good throw over to Wozniak for out number three. We go to the bottom of the fourth. It's Redbirds 2, Norsemen 2 on CTN.
7,000 high school students drop out every school day. Let's catch them before it's too late. To start helping students in your community, visit boostup.org.
Through three and a half innings, we have a tie score between the Brooklyn Park Norsemen and the Coon Rapids Redbirds.
Redbirds out hitting the Norsemen 4-2. Another one for Brandon Rickert.
Jared Vance fouling off the first pitch. This one hit back up the middle, scooped up by Skog. The throw in time to Bruner for out number one.
Nice quick first out for the Redbirds in the field. Dan Skog with a nice play at short, easy pickup. Throw over to Bruner at the bag for out number one.
And now Calvin Spencer, first pitch, fouled off. High to center, Paler drifting back and then even further. He had a tough time judging that one, but he does reel it in.
He made it an
adventure.
Round
number two.
You'll have to adjust at the end. Make sure you brought that one in.
Kept having to go back a little bit more. And now Brandon Wozniak tempted at the high heat, but maintains his patience and gets ahead in the count 1-0. Can't catch up with that fastball, and it's even at 1-1.
Yeah, Lewis has pitched a nice outing so far since coming in early in the first relief of Carson Saleen.
Four strikeouts, his first time through the order, including one against this batter right here. He did that back in the second inning with a 1-2 pitch. Here's a 1-2 pitch in the fourth, and it's fouled back right at the announcer's face. I don't know if the batter maybe was trying to tell me something.
Shut up. I've had it with you, Yon.
Another 1-2 offering from Lewis. Fastball down low, 2-2. Pop back, out of play. And we'll try again.
Another one for Rickert.
It's good. Foul balls are great. Gives the youngins at the ball game something to do. Two and two with two out. The curveball down the line and foul.
Yeah, good thought again, just trying to poke that one over Bruner at first.
Fine. Fastball, this one right back to Lewis. Takes a couple steps off, throws over to Bruner. For out number three, Lewis retires him in order. In the fourth, we go to the fifth. Redbirds 2, Norsemen 2. You're watching Metro Mini Baseball on CTN.
A full life measured in seats starts with the right ones early on. Car crashes are the number one killer of children 1 through 13. Learn how to prevent deaths and injuries by using the right car seat for your child's age and size.
Rough start to the ball game for starter Carson Salini. Walked the first four he faced, and the Norsemen had a 1-0 lead. But the Redbirds come back. They score the first and tying run on a pass ball. Then an RBI single by Dan Skog. Put them ahead 2-1. Norsemen scratched out another run in the bottom of the third to even things up. And that's where we are through four.
In case you're watching this and knowing we're at Wintercrest and realize why the Redbirds are the visitors, this is an opportunity for a home game for Brooklyn Park. And they will play it on the home field of the Redbirds.
Top of the order for the Redbirds here in the fifth inning. Big swinging strike.
And that pitch just a little bit up in the zone, but Paler definitely swinging through it.
Breaking pitch, fouled off. Keep Paler alive at 0-2. Fastball hit toward the left side. Lions on the backhand, the throw just in time to Brandon Wozniak for out number one.
Lions with a nice arm, except the ball is hit a little deep to the hole and short. And one fluid motion, able to get it over to first. Baylor's got some wheels, too.
Plenty of time. Dan Skog, as we talked about, the RBI single last time up. This one hit down the line and left. A diving effort, and what a catch by Trevor Kaminsky.
Wow.
A diving full extension grab by the left fielder for the second out.
Watch this play. Skog thought he had a base hit, but Kaminsky's coming over, and he's going to lay out for this. Just a beautiful catch. Able to look that right into the glove for the out. Pretty.
And now Keen Paxton with two out, nobody on. Pitches outside. Up high, 2-0. Goes down after that one and pops it up behind third base over calling off his Lions. And that's a pretty quick fifth inning on both halves. We go to the sixth, 2-2. Sorry, that's going to the bottom of the fifth.
That is correct.
2-2 on CTN.
Same time next week?
Well, of course.
Put away a few bucks, feel like a million bucks. For free tips to help you save, go to
Feed the Pig.
Really?
Buzz, what's up, man? You left some leaves burning out here.
Yeah, I just came in just for a second.
Come on, man. If it's too hot to touch, it's too hot to leave. You could torch the whole neighborhood.
It's a good point there, Smokey.
9 out of 10 wildfires are caused by humans.
Only you can prevent wildfires.
Lights coming on a beautiful night at Wintercrest. We got a good ball game cooking, middle of the fifth inning. 2-2 our score.
It's our last game of the summer. Last television broadcast of the summer before football starts on the 22nd of August.
Tony Zajac struck out swinging back in the second. Now leading off the fifth. Got a piece of that. It's 1-1. Down and away, 2-1.
Well, Lewis has been living in that low heat so far this evening and doing a pretty good job with it.
We'll see how long he pitches. I guarantee he wasn't expecting to come here and throw 5 innings.
No, it was not.
Easy play from Sather across the diamond to Bruner for out number one.
Well, the Redbird bullpen is active.
But I don't know.
Looks like Mark Lundholm getting
how
some
often
throws.
Bruner is starting.
Lewis,
yeah. How often Lewis is starting and how many innings he's used to throwing, but doing a pretty nice job of it right now. Back to the top of the order. Lyons popped it up wide of first his last time up. This one hit toward the gap on the left side and through a one out single.
A nice piece of hitting by Lyons with one away.
Just the second hit of the game for Brooklyn Park.
Third, isn't it? Or is it the second?
I'm checking. Double checking because I know we've had two on. No, that's just the second hit. This one skied back off the backstop.
That was almost yours.
If only I were a little taller.
It had really long arms.
Kaminsky reached on a pass ball. He struck out his last time up, reached on a pass ball, and up scoring the second run of the ball game for the Norsemen. Tying this one up back in the bottom of the third. Runner is going. This one poked towards second. Charging on it is Tutt. The throw over to Bruner. And they get the out.
Yeah, not much Tutt could do about getting that runner at second. But now with two down, just be concerned about that hitter at the plate.
But with the hit and run on.
Right.
Patrick last time.
Sowall with a nice base hit last time up.
Lewis starts him with a curveball inside, 1-0. That one down off of the dish. Skips way over. Lyons a big turn at third because Stein had no idea where it was.
See it again, the pitch getting behind Stein. In the dirt, off his glove.
Runner advances to third, two out. A 2-0 count to Kaminsky, or to Sowall. Good
pitch.
Fastball, yep. In for a strike.
You're talking about, you know, I think Lewis only had 10 and a third innings coming into this game.
This one hit hard, but right at Bruner. Easy play as he jogs to first. And that will leave that runner stranded. We go to the sixth, 2-2 from Winter Gress Park.
Did you know the lion's sense of vision is so powerful? It actually enables nearby creatures to see better. Here we see lions assisting the offspring of others, while their parents are elsewhere in the wild. Brilliant, isn't it? Making the wild kingdom look much better indeed. Do good. Be a lion.
Brandon Rushmeyer back on the mound. His first 1-2-3 inning of the ball game coming in the fifth.
Again, not a lot of offense for either one of these teams. Saw four hits for the Redbirds, two for the Norsemen.
Grant Farley looks at an off-speed pitch, strike one. Now a curveball that doesn't have enough curve to it. Fastball hit back on the left side. Diving on it is Solwald. The throw is in the dirt and not in time anyhow. Midfield single to lead things off for Grant Farley.
Yeah, it would have been tough for Solwald to make that out, but nice job of just keeping it in the infield. And with Farley's speed, he was definitely not going to get him.
He didn't really dive. He just kind of pounced on it.
Yeah, fell on it.
That'll bring up Patrick O'Donnell. With a runner at first, nobody out. Behind him, Zach Sather. Sather, 2-for-2 so far tonight. Fastball, and O'Donnell a little behind. Whoa, 1-1.
Got a big swing and a miss by O'Donnell as the Redbirds trying to get something going offensively here.
One and one. Up high. Rushmeyer missing inside, and it's a hitter's count at 3-1 for Patrick O'Donnell.
Yeah, O'Donnell will definitely take this free pass. If he can work
or
it.
Or what could be a fat pitch right here.
Yep, yeah, or it could be a very fat pitch.
1-on, nobody out. Rushmeyer would love to not walk the second run on. And he will find the outside edge there for strike two and a full count. Just one walk allowed thus far for Rushmeyer as he starts his sixth inning. Giving up the five hits, two runs. Only one of them earned. Hit one batter. Two strikeouts. Full count pitch, ripped down the line, foul. And we'll try again.
And Farley off with that pitch. He'll be able to keep that one fair. Good thought down the line.
See if Farley goes again, they're going to get it, and they nailed him. Got him leaning. And a good pickoff from Brandon Rushmeyer to Brandon Wozniak.
It looked like they had him leaning before, play before that where he threw over. This time, just leaning a little bit too much. You saw him go the other way. Nice job by Rushmeyer to get the throw over the bag, pick him off. That's a way to eliminate the base runner.
This one hit high to right center. Long run for both outfielders. Ajak bobbles and can't control it. O'Donnell standing up with a stand-up double.
Had it in his glove but dropped it. You can see it here on the replay. Some of the fans behind us thought he caught it, and from their view, I understand.
He did for a second.
Yeah. Had it in his glove, but you can see it coming out there. And there it's on the ground.
Had it for a second.
Yeah, he did. He did have it in the glove for a second.
It was a decent acting job as he kind of rolled over with the ball up. So that'll put a runner at second, one out. And how big was that?
Huge.
That pickoff.
Huge. Say they're having a nice night at the dish. Good opportunity for him.
Pops up the first one left side, just wide of third. Solwald underneath makes the catch for out number two.
Of course, and as soon as I say that, he pops out to third base.
And a big second out for the Norseman.
Huge, because he'd been having a good night. You can just see him got underneath that baseball, not happy with himself. Solwald playing foul territory.
Bring up Tyler Stein. Fouls back to first pitch. Good pitch
nice
right
pitch.
There, and it froze Stein, gets Rushmeyer heading the count 0-2. Rushmeyer looks at the runner, now comes home with the 0-2 pitch. Driven toward the gap in left center. This one's going to fall. Coming around to score is O'Donnell. Big turn at first, but Stein satisfied with the RBI single to put his team back in front. 3-2.
Nice piece of hitting by Tyler Stein as he's able to get that go-ahead run with the single.
And we'll have 24.
I wish I knew who that was.
The courtesy runner. M- Mystery Man 2-4.
Tony Kaminsky, head coach for Norseman, taking a walk to the mound, talking to Rushmeyer. He's pitched a pretty good game.
He has. Some timely hitting, though. Three hits in the inning for the Redbirds. And without that pickoff at first, they could have put up a crooked number here.
Absolutely.
Bring up Jake Bruner. Trying to keep the Redbirds' success alive in the sixth. Expecting fastball, he got the changeup and he's way out in front.
0-for-2 with a couple of strikeouts is Jake Bruner for the evening.
A great pitch right there. A little bit of a cutter in for a strike, 0-2. Rushmeyer back to the fastball, blows it past him to end the inning. Redbirds get another and take a 3-2 lead as we go to the bottom of the sixth on CTF.
When you watch CTN News, you'll notice we're different. It's about the people, the places, the stories that affect your life.
We're local. We focus on the local communities, the local issues, and the local stories.
They're the stories that impact you, the stories you won't find anywhere else.
It's the people, the places, and the events that make CTN so interesting.
It's about connecting you to your community, one story at a time.
Joe Lewis set to start his sixth inning in relief, and he has been very solid. One run allowed on two hits with five strikeouts.
Yeah, after the rough start by Carson Saleen, Redbirds thought they were going to be in a little bit of a hole, but they were able to get out of it. Really thanks to Joe Lewis.
First pitch rolled back to the left side, scooped up by Skog. The throw is in time. One pitch, one out to start the sixth.
That's the way they like it, get a quick inning after taking the lead, if they possibly can. Skog with the pickup and the throw over to Bruner.
Daniel Kelb 0-for-2, couple of strikeouts. One looking, one swinging.
Actually, that's Brett Meyer, number 33 for the Norsemen. First at bat for Meyer. Meyer's hitting a .152 as he steps to the plate.
Lewis trying to work low, a little bit too low. It's 2-1. Pitch had a little drop on it and a little too much. It's 3-1. And ball four. First walk allowed for Joe Lewis. And I blame it on Shapiro.
It's always my fault. Why is it my fault?
Well, because he called for a quick inning.
That's true. They did call for a quick inning.
After getting the quick first out. The Shapiro jinx. Up comes Jared Vance, hit into a double play.
I was just going to say, if it hits into another double play, then that'll be a quick inning.
Hit into a double play back in the first, a ground ball to short, his last time up. Good fastball on the outside half, 0-1. This one chopped to the left side. Second hop, they get the out at second, but there won't be time for a turn because of how high that first hop was.
A little bit of a delay by our officials making sure that he had the possession of the baseball. Take another look at it. Close play at the bag.
Bring up Calvin Spencer, a couple of fly balls so far tonight. First pitch out in front of the changeup, 0-1. Runner at first, two outs here in the bottom of the sixth inning. And they're going to call a balk.
Yep.
And that'll put that tying run into scoring position.
Again, looked like he made a movement, didn't come to a stop.
Batter calls time. Now digs back in, an 0-1 count for Calvin Spencer. Fastball in for a strike. 0-2.
And now, again, good situation for Joe Lewis here, heading the count 0-2. He's got some pitches to play with.
Goes back to the fastball, but misses down and away, and Spencer holds off 1-2. A piece of that, and it got a piece of him. Spencer has to walk it off a little bit.
Stings a little bit, but you're going to see it again here as he's going to get a piece of the ball, and you mentioned the ball got a piece of him right on the foot. I don't even know if he did he swing through that. Didn't look like he got any contact on it.
Outside, 2-2. And a big swinging strikeout for out number three leaves that potential tying run stranded at second. We go to the seventh, Redbirds leading the Norsemen 3-2 on CTN.
Every day across America, excess food is gathered by a network of good people at local food banks, giving hope to millions of children who struggle with hunger. They've earned their wings, and you can too. Together, we can solve child hunger. Support Feeding America and your local food bank at feedingamerica.org.
I've got a job to do today.
I've got a job to do today.
Thank you.
work well.
Your donations to Goodwill fund job training programs right in your community.
Feels good to start fresh, right?
Sure does.
And like that, you're a job creator.
You see it, Brooklyn Park is able to take advantage of some opportunities without really getting a lot of wood on the ball.
No, only two hits on the evening. Not a lot of hits from the Redbird side, just six, but nonetheless, they held that 3-2 lead. Brandon Rushmeyer, nice night on the hill.
And I know what a fan you are of pitch count. Here's the numbers. Through six innings, 81 pitches for Brandon Rushmeyer, 80 for Joe Lewis.
You can't get more closer than that.
58 of the 81 for strikes for Brandon Rushmeyer. And now starts this inning ahead 1-2 against Jeremy Tutt. We've lost my microphone again.
Just a little bit.
What did we do last time?
I think you put your left foot in and then took your left foot out.
Just wiggle some cables.
Wiggle some cables and hope it comes back.
This one shot back up the middle, got past Rushmeyer, bobbled by Vance, and that's going to be an infield single. Just hit it in a real tough spot and got the leadoff man aboard with the leadoff single.
And the Redbirds getting that leadoff runner on, trying to take advantage of it. Now holding a 3-2 lead, trying to get a little insurance on that lead.
Well, they got the leadoff single last inning, only to have that runner picked off before O'Donnell's little bloop double. Or they could have had a
bigger lead,
another run or more in that sixth inning. But Tutt on base and the lineup flips over. Jake Paler dropped down a sacrifice. Dropped down a sacrifice in the third and then reached on a throwing error and ended up scoring what at the time was the go-ahead run at 2-1. Had success with that push bunt down the first baseline last time. He tries it again, but foul.
See if he offers one more time.
Nope, he's going to foul this one back to the backstop. Rushmeyer ahead in the count 0-2. And a pretty healthy lead over there for Jeremy Tutt. I don't know if you want to. Bait the pickoff from Brandon Rushmeyer too many times after the pickoff he got last inning.
Well, he's yet to steal a base on the season.
That pitch floats in a little bit high to Paler, 1-2. This one hit well to right, coming in on it, but it's going to fall in front of Zajac. Back-to-back singles to start the inning for Coon Rapids.
Yeah, at first I wasn't sure if Zajac was going to be able to make a play on the ball. But as you mentioned, that one's going to fall in front of him. Back-to-back knocks.
Not a lot on either of those hits, but they're effective and put runners on. Now Dan Skog, an RBI single back in the third. Drops down a bunt, and it's a good one. Rushmeyer Fields looking to third, and not in time. Good speed from Jeremy Tutt. They're all loaded up on the bunt single.
Yeah, and that was an important play for Brooklyn Park because they wanted to get that out at third base, but unfortunately for them, Tutt a little too fast. Gets to the bag before the throw.
Well, and now the base is all loaded up, nobody out, and the heart of the order coming up for the Coon Rapids Redbirds.
Yeah, they want to see if they can break it open here.
D.H. Keen Paxton takes a pitch below the knees, 1-0. Paxton a walk and a couple of pop-ups. And now a fastball up high, 2-0.
I'm not sure. Well, there's a little bit of a work in the dugout for Brooklyn Park.
That one finds the zone, and 2-1 the count to Keen Paxton.
Sam Bozick getting some throws in for the Norseman.
Foul back, out of play. And it's 2-2.
Kids having fun chasing the ball.
Bases full of Redbirds. Nobody out. A 2-2 count to Keen Paxton. Rushmeyer delivers, and it's a line drive to center. One run is going to score. They're going to push Paler in his way. No, they're going to hold Paler.
Nice throw in, too.
And it would have been a close, close play. Kelb got it in quickly and put it on a rope to Austin Ledeen. RBI single for Keen Paxton, though. Pushes the Redbirds' lead to 4-2.
Paxton with a nice piece of hitting to get that RBI, push that lead up.
See the run. That'll be it for Brandon Rushmeyer. We will take a break with this pitching change and be back to the ballpark after this on CTF.
Kids will spend 8 minutes decorating their little brother.
Brushing for 2 minutes now can save your child from severe tooth pain later. 2 minutes, twice a day. They have the time.
Jimmy can't sing.
And Tommy can't dance.
So we're gonna put some ants in their pants.
Aww. Kids will spend 22 minutes watching us, the super duper party troopers, sing about ants in their pants.
Isn't that funny? Ants in their pants, they got ants in their pants. They've got ants in their pants.
Brushing for 2 minutes now can save your child from severe tooth pain later. 2 minutes, twice a day. They have the time.
So both starting pitchers leave the game with the bases loaded, nobody out, and one run already across in the inning. For Brooklyn Park, it doesn't happen until the seventh inning. For Coon Rapids, it happened way back in the first. But Bozak inheriting quite a situation here.
Yeah, bases loaded, nobody out. Comes in with a 2-1 record overall and a 2.15 earned run average. He has 28 strikeouts in 25 innings.
And a good hitter in Grant Farley digging in for the Redbirds, trying to extend this lead here in the later innings. Fastball in, strike one.
Dean coming out and talking to Posa quickly after that first pitch.
You think he said, don't throw a fastball.
Don't groove one.
Don't throw a belt high fastball down the middle of this guy again. Please.
Yep.
Bozick comes back with an off-speed pitch, and it pops straight up on the left side. Calling off on it is Lyons. He'll catch it for out number one.
That's a,
whatever they discussed at the mound, apparently quite effective.
You can see him get underneath that. A relatively easy play from Lyons.
Now Patrick O'Donnell, bloop double his last time up. Fastball in for a strike. I mean, it looked like Kelb made a great play on the ball, but just unable to keep it in his glove. Or was it Zajac? It was Zajac, yeah, coming over from right. Made the diving play, got the glove on it, but just couldn't hold on to it.
Get another meeting at the mound.
Maybe that's their thing.
Go out every couple pitches.
Well, anytime you get to an 0-1 count. So hopefully every at bat, every batter. Unless you get one pitch outs. Down and in, 1-1. Good curveball right there. A lot of movement on it. 1-2 as it completely froze Patrick O'Donnell. Bozick trying to work out of a jam. That one skips and goes to the backstop. All runners are going to advance. Paler will come in with the run. It's 5-2 in favor of the Redbirds.
The Redbirds able to pad that lead. Wild pitch allows them to score that fifth run. As we talked about, a lot of real estate behind home plate.
Nothing Ledeen could do about that one. That one skipped off the dirt in front of the plate. And once it was by him, there was no chance. 2-2 now the count to O'Donnell. Runners at second and third. This one chopped to the right side. It'll bring in another run. It's a ground out to second, but it pushes the lead to 6-2 for the Redbird.
It does, does his job by getting the sacrifice. Mentioned that nowhere else for Vance to go other than
infield was in, yep. And even with the infield in, it took such a high hop, he had no chance to get Sather coming home. Needed the out, got it at first, and now Zach Sather trying to see if he can keep this inning alive and get his third hit of the ball game. Fastball misses low, 2-0. Fastball hit back up the middle, right into no man's land. They will turn Paxton. He is coming home. He will score an RBI single for Sather. And it's a four-run inning to open this game up to a 7-2 lead for the Redbirds.
Yeah, they've done a nice job of putting runs together here. And Sather with another base hit. Get his, as you mentioned, get his third now of the game.
First four hitters of the inning for the Redbirds got hits. All four would score. Five hits in the inning. Now is Sather's RBI single. Fastball for a strike at the knees to Tyler Stein. He had an RBI single his last time at the plate. This time, rip right back up the middle. Nice backhanded stop by Vance. The flip over to Lyons covering the bag for out number three. But four runs score And it's a 7-2 Redbird lead going to the bottom of the seventh inning. Back at Wintercrest, a big inning for the Redbirds as the Mountain Front 7-2 as we get ready for the bottom of the seventh inning.
New pitcher for the Redbirds, Mark Lundholm. What's his number, Joe?
Number nine.
Comes in with a 2-0 record, a 3.73 earned run average. Was pitched 55 and a third innings, allowed 43 hits, 17 earned runs. I'm sorry, 17 runs, 12 of them earned, giving up a couple of long balls. Has 27 strikeouts in those 55 and a third innings.
So Joe Lewis, a great job in relief again, coming in way before he expected to, but pitching six strong innings, giving up just the one run on a couple of hits, one walk, five strikeouts. It's a nice night.
Tom Potter now the new hitter for Brooklyn Park. Not a lot of plate appearances.
Six strikeouts.
Just
I
nine.
Apologize.
Hitting .444 on the season. It'll be Tom Potter. No relation to Rob.
That we know of. 1-1 the count to Potter to start off the seventh inning for the Norsemen. Little check swing foul, 1-2. Very different delivery for Lundholm
yep.
than what they saw from Joe Lewis, and of course coming from the opposite side of the mound. Misses down and away with the fastball, 2-2. Foul and out of play. Another foul. Potter gonna battle up here.
Trying to work that left field line.
And what was a ball game before this inning started, all of a sudden now the Norsemen have to be looking at it as only nine outs left to try and dig their way out of the hole.
That's become a pretty good sized one.
Another 2-2 pitch. Floats in high in a full count. Potter getting his money's worth in his first at bat. This will be the ninth pitch he'll see from Lundholm. It's a fastball and it's fouled out of play. We'll keep going.
We're gonna run out of baseball soon here.
Okay. Another fastball, another foul.
Same spot.
Misses low, and after an 11 pitch at bat, Potter earns the leadoff walk. That is the definition of a quality AB.
Absolutely.
Getting you on base. Tony Zajac, 0 for 2 with a strikeout. First pitch, foul down the third baseline. Great curve. Zajac turned away from it and it fell right back over the plate. I just want to point out 11 pitches to the first batter he faced for Lundholm. In the last three innings, big swinging strikeout, a nice way to follow up the walk. That one on just three pitches. But Lewis had finished the sixth with 14, 13 in the fifth, 12 in the fourth.
He was efficient.
He only threw 10 pitches in the second and 9 in the third, or in the first. Of course, he did get a double play ball.
He did. Helps you.
Helps the pitch count.
Helps the pitch count.
Help the team for sure.
Absolutely. Helps you in the field.
Back to the top of the order for the Norsemen. A.J. Lyons looks at a pitch outside. Speed pitch, hit back to the left side. Sather gets the great turn in the middle by Tutt. Bruner finishes it off, and that is a 5-4-3 inning double play.
I've got a job to do today.
I've got a job to do today.
Mom.
Your donations to Goodwill fund job training programs right in your community.
Feels good to start fresh, right?
Sure does.
And like that, you're a job creator.
A single ember from a wildfire can travel over a mile. That ember can ignite and destroy your home or community. You can't control where that ember will land. Only what happens before it does. Visit fireadapted.org to learn how you can help protect your community from wildfires.
I've been waiting for it all night. It is 8-bit, eighth inning. Thank you, Brian Trausch.
The man.
Spectacular. Spectacular. Well, 24 is going to bat. He's playing at first now. He's got a beard similar to Adam Wedwick. I think that is Adam Wedwick.
It very well could be. He changed his number, though. It was 10 before. Yeah, I think you're right. It is Adam Wedwick. You're correct.
Big swinging strike.
Told Noah Koss, but I don't think that's Noah Koss.
high and outside. Very few of these athletes that I recognize outside of the number.
Nice pitch.
Wedwick punched out on strikes and a good start to the inning for Sam Bozick. His first strikeout of the game. Now Jeremy Tutt. 2 for 3, he's scored twice. Pitch down to the dirt, 1-0. Love to see that from your number 9 hitter.
Number 9.
2 for 3 with a couple of runs scored.
Well, here's an interesting major league fact that just came over the wire.
This one popped up right side, wide of first, back on it for the catch. Is not Wozniak. That's Tom Potter now.
That is Tom Potter. The Rangers' Adrian Beltre hit for the cycle in the first 5 innings of a game tonight. Hit a triple in the first, a double in the second, a single in the third, and a home run in the fifth. That's a pretty good night for 5 innings. Potter able to haul in that second out.
Jake Paler looks at a fastball for a strike. And another one right on the corner at the knees.
You see the numbers on Paler for the night, 1 for 5, 2 runs in his, scored and a single in his hit, or his hit.
A speed pitch, blew back up the middle, and it's going to fall right in between 3 defenders. Doesn't have to be hit too hard as long as it's hit to where they aim. Texas leaguer, blooper.
It. Doesn't matter.
Dying quail. Whatever you want to call it.
A dying quail.
They're all line drives in the box score. Two out single for Paler will bring up Dan Skog. 2 for 3. Scored once, drove one in. Looks at a pitch, strike one.
Northwood running out of outs here. They just want to get back to the plate. They certainly do not want to give anything up here top of the eighth.
Fastball in, strike two. One hit to third, backhanded there by Solwald. Plenty of time to make the throw over, and not a great throw.
No, he's safe.
Potter unable to dig it out. That'll go in as an error, and it'll keep the inning alive.
See it here. It's a nice pickup, but the throw, as you mentioned, in the dirt, off the glove. Potter couldn't control it.
So the inning will continue. Keen Paxton. RBI single, scored a run in that 4-run seventh. Outside of that, a walk in 3 trips. Good pitch right there to even the count, 1-1. Fastball misses wide, 2-1.
Well, good eye by Paxton at the plate.
Well, it seemed it might be a quick inning. They got the first two pretty quickly, then the little bloop single by Paler and an error on the throw across. And that pitch down in the dirt and then bobbled by Ledeen. And Paler hustles over to third.
Yeah, smartly takes third base.
And a 3-1 count to Keen Paxton. Oh, it's 2-2. Sorry.
2-2.
I knew that.
Just out here.
That's right. He swung at that pitch in the dirt. This one driven to right, a solid single will bring Paler home from third.
That stolen base paid off, produced a run. Makes it 8-2 now in favor of the Redbirds. A nice piece of hitting by Paxton. He's turned on that pitch.
Bring up Grant Farley, 1-for-4 so far tonight. Holds off on the pitch low in the zone, 1-0. Fastball.
Called it a strike.
He did?
He did.
Farley backed away, thought it was inside, but clipped the corner, 1-1. Skied another one, right side this time. Vance underneath it, makes the catch. And that's out number three. Redbirds get one more. They lead 8-2 in the middle of the eighth inning.
I've got a job to do today.
I've got a job to do today.
First day at work, Mom.
Your donations to Goodwill fund job training programs right in your community.
Feels good to start fresh, right?
Sure does.
And like that, you're a job creator.
Look at me.
Hey.
Raymond, look at Mommy.
Maybe the light hurts his eyes.
Maybe she's just not hungry.
Maybe he can't hear us.
Maybe we're not stimulating him enough. Maybe it's a phase.
Avoiding eye contact is one early sign of autism. Learn the others today. The sooner it's diagnosed, the better.
Coats out at the ballpark.
Yeah, it's a little chilly. Got a little chilly here as it gets in the later innings.
Another pitching change for the Redbirds as Taylor Nelson will take over on the hill for the eighth.
And I think Justin Reeves will be the new catcher.
He will. Trevor Kaminsky first to face Nelson, and that fastball misses just low, 1-0.
Nelson comes in with a 4-2 record, a 1.95 earned run average.
Misses down and away, 2-0. Kaminsky fouls that one off, got out in front of it a little bit. 2-1. And now 3-1. One hit well to right, but right at Patrick O'Donnell for out number one.
Nice job after fall behind the count, getting him, inducing him to hit a fly ball to the outfield. You mentioned O'Donnell not having to move very far to record that out.
That'll bring up the third baseman, Seth Solwald. Solwald 1-for-2. Single and a walk. Foul back and out of play. A good pitch right there to get Nelson ahead in the count 0-2.
Yeah, working that inside portion of the plate. Nice pitch by Nelson.
Took something off of it, but Solwald not fooled. 1-2. This one hit foul. One hit sharply but fouled on the other line. See a little work going in the Norseman bullpen.
Yeah, I couldn't tell who it was.
1-2. Skied and hooking foul and out of play. Solwald battling with two strikes.
Looking for their 25th win on the season.
Fastball hit right back up in the middle. Nelson got a piece of it, scooped up by Skog. Throw dug out nicely at first by Adam Wedwick.
Yeah, Skog got a little bit of a smile for thanking his first base minder for bailing him out on that ground ball, low throw in the dirt. Again, just a nice job. You're going to see it flipping it. Good backhanded stop.
It's a 1-6-3. Because Nelson definitely got a piece of it.
Absolutely.
We'll bring out Boston Ledeen. 0 for 2. He has reached base twice and did get the bases loaded walk to give him an RBI back in the first. This one skied. And just beyond the infield, Skog actually in the infield. A little miscommunication, but plenty of time to recover as that one was a mile high. 8 complete, Redbirds 8, Norseman 2. You're watching Metro Mini Baseball on CTA.
You sure you don't want some? It's chamomile.
You are extremely terrifying. Just the scariest undead subhuman thing on TV, and I really mean that. But I am worried that you could give my kids nightmares if they see you, so I'm gonna have to block you. So that's it. Oh, and tell the zombies they're blocked too.
Hey, going out like that?
Yeah, why?
Well, what would the neighbors think?
I see you! Come look at Mr. Feather!
Look what I have.
Mr. Bird, remember? Bark, bark, bark! We're just playing! We're just playing! I'm trying to get you out of here!
Even still.
You don't have to be perfect to be a perfect parent. There are thousands of teens in foster care who don't need perfection. They need you.
Redbirds sitting pretty as we start the ninth, an 8-2 lead. It was a game that they trailed early. And it looked like the Norsemen may be able to really open things up big in that first inning, but just a great job by Joe Lewis coming in on short notice.
Absolutely.
Shutting the door in that first, leaving the bases loaded, and then pitching 6 strong innings.
Now we have another pitcher for Brooklyn Park. That's Trevor Kaminsky.
It is indeed. So who's out and left?
Who's on first?
34.
34 left. Four is, that would be Sam Bozek. He went out from, they switched spots.
Of course they did.
You knew that.
Why wouldn't they?
Makes sense.
Absolutely. 'Sather, Stein, and Wedwick.
Actually, it's Patrick O'Donnell.
I hope you're right. O'Donnell, Sather, and Stein. I was a step ahead, sorry. O'Donnell, Sather, and Stein, the scheduled batters. Pitch up high. And now down low, 2-0. Foul back and out of play by O'Donnell. Fastball foul out of play. And it's 2-2.
Oh, that almost got Rickert. Kaminsky comes in with a 3-run
almost
record.
Almost is not close enough.
No,
a 1-2. Those guys are not earning the pay I offered. Low 3-2.
Well, Rickert's got that cat-like quickness up there.
O'Donnell able to get a piece of that one, stay alive at 3-2. That one hit to right, and it's going to be a solid single to start things off here in the ninth.
Well, the hit parade continues for Coon Rapids. Solid piece of hitting by O'Donnell there.
Bring up Zach Sather, 3-for-4. An RBI, nice night so far. Would love to keep that streak going here in the ninth inning.
Absolutely.
No lead is ever too big.
Nope. It's always good to get some insurance. Continue to get some insurance. 6 runs. It's pretty hefty.
This one right back up the middle. And they'll get the out at first as well.
Yep.
Just hitting the right spot. Lions fielded it right behind second. Easy tag and throw over for the double play.
Actually brings up Justin Reeves. You see the double play there. Reeves hitting a .143.
Foul back to the backstop. 0-2.
We're back. Pushed him back a little bit.
A little chin music.
Yep.
Don't
crowd
get
that plate.
Too comfortable in that batter's box.
Don't
one
hug
and
that
two.
Plate. That's
great curveball. And a very efficient inning after giving up a leadoff single after a long battle, a double play, and a strikeout. And now the Norsemen will try and rally in the bottom of the ninth when we return on CTA.
And we're out.
You got plans?
You bet.
$50 million Americans struggle with hunger. But we can do something about it.
Excuse me, what's going on?
Dinner. Please join me in helping put food on their tables. Together, we can feed America.
You guys keep going. I'm gonna get the plates.
Plates?
Find your local food bank at feedingamerica.org/hunger.
Wow, these are really good.
You act surprised. Practice makes perfect.
You don't have to be perfect to be a perfect parent. There are thousands of teens in foster care who don't need perfection. They need you.
Redbirds trying to close out a solid victory. Brooklyn Park, just 2 hits against the Redbirds pitching staff.
It's new pitcher of record, Andrew Dreesen. Andrew comes in with a 2-0 record, a .64 earned run.
Let's hope he does not become a pitcher of record, because
no.
The only way he becomes a pitcher of record is if he gives up six.
Gives up six. He's pitched 28 innings.
Or seven, actually.
Seven, right.
Right now, the pitchers of record would be Joe Lewis.
Right.
Who stands to get the victory for the Redbirds. And Brandon Rushmeyer had a solid start and went six strong innings before struggling to start the seventh. Gave up four straight hits to start the seventh is where his night ended. And unfortunately for him, he had given up three runs through six innings. All four of those runs would later score. Brett Meyer leading off his second at bat. He walked his first time up. This one fouled back and out of play. And Dreesen quickly ahead in the count 0-2.
That foul ball had Brandon Ricker ducking a little bit. Right over his head. Gave him a little bit of a haircut.
Well, apparently Meyer got my memo on the bounty offered.
Held up on that one.
That one nearly had him swinging. Instead, he holds on, and it's 1-2. Changes the level there, but Meyer not even tempted at the pitch up and away. 2-2. Fastball hit well to right center. It's going to fall for a leadoff hit.
That's the way that the Northmen wanted to start. They know they have a big hole to dig out of, trailing by six. Falling in front of O'Donnell.
And now Jared Vance trying to keep this rally going. First pitch hit right at second. That's a double play. Oh no, he dropped it.
Didn't hold the ball.
Meyer got a little bit lucky there.
Yeah, absolutely did. It should have been a double play.
That was hit right at Jeremy Tutt.
Yeah, again. In his glove.
Oh yeah, and he was out by two steps.
Yeah.
Spencer fouls off the first offering. Nice pitch right there,
yeah,
and
big
Spencer
swing.
Out in front of the changeup 0-2. And then goes swinging underneath the high heat. Strikeout for out number two. Norseman down to their final tally, and now they really need a rally.
They do need a rally. I don't see the rally caps on in the dugout, though.
Six runs, hard enough to score with three outs, much less once you're down to one. Tom Potter's second at bat. His first at bat, an epic battle, went 11 pitches before earning the walk. He was later out as part of the beautifully turned around the horn 5-4-3 double play. A couple double plays in the ballgame for the Redbirds, both started by third baseman Zach Saylor.
And that's where Potter likes to go with those foul balls, is in that area.
He has
in left field over the foul fence.
You know, he is not easy on the ball.
No,
boys.
No, he makes them
run. Work.
Yep,
earn their money. Yeah,
they
5-2 strike fouls last time. This one grounded to short. The throw in time, and this one's over.
A nice win for the Redbirds. You know, after what looked like the first inning was going to be a tough one for them. Bases loaded, nobody out. Just one run coming across, and Redbirds did a nice job of piling up their runs, and they will get their 25th victory of the year. Their record will go to 25-11. The Norsemen drop their record to 11-8 on the season.
Yeah, the big four-run seventh inning really opened it up, but you can't say enough about the job Joe Lewis did.
Absolutely.
Coming in with the bases loaded, nobody out, and one run already across in the bottom of the first inning, and he threw six very strong innings, giving up just one run on two hits, six strikeouts, one walk, and he will get the victory for it because his bats came to town for him.
They did.
And got the job done. And once they had the big lead, they went to the bullpen, and the bullpen closed it out with three shutout innings.
It was a nice win for him. Again, good hit parade for the Redbirds. 12 hits on the evening, and another win to get them 25.
And a great opportunity for us to get down to the ball game.
Absolutely.
And our last for the summer.
Yes.
It has been a fantastic summer.
Yes, it really has.
For
a lot of
the
fun.
CTN crew, but that is going to be it. Look at the hustle from
Shapiro. Yeah, baby.
But that is going to do it for this edition of CTN Sports. Again, the final score from Wintercrest, it's the Redbirds 8, the Norsemen 2. I want to thank everybody out there for joining us to continue to support everything we do here at CTN for the entire crew, including Howard Shapiro. I'm Joe Young saying goodnight.